And hello there, 93.9 KPDQ. It's your spot for faith and family. About 10 minutes left in our show. This is the Northwest Showcase, and Dr. David Day is here from Day Chiropractic, 503-760-7572. That is his number, 503-760-7572. You'll find Day Chiropractic at 3758 Southeast 122nd Avenue, right between Powell and Foster. Great to have Dr. Day here, and we're just having fun. We're just talking about chiropractic and how so much of the body is controlled by what I call the breaker box.
Yes, yes. But it's so interesting, the consequence then of the breaker box on the brain.
Right, right.
And so I have an article that we passed out talking about spinal problems reduce blood flow to the brain. You go, well, how do we do that?
Yeah.
You know, because now we all know if you have, like we've all experienced when we stand up too fast and we get dizzy, that's an example of hypoperfusion. That's orthostatic hypotension, right? It didn't come up, the column of blood didn't keep squirting into the brain when you stood up too fast.
Yeah, okay. So what happens when the...
Well, then you have to hold on to something and let the blood come back up. And you know, sometimes it's a sign that there's something with your autonomic nerve system. And we can all test for all that sort of stuff. Mm-hmm. And people who have low blood pressure tend to have a little bit more issues along with that. Okay, but let's think not just that one type of condition. Let's also think about, here's a study. Vertebral subluxations are linked with cerebral hypoperfusion. So here, this thing was published in the JMPT, Journal of Manipulative and Physiological Therapeutics. It enrolled 29 women and 16 men with chronic neck, chronic upper back pain, or both. All right. So the patients underwent a specialized form of CAT scan, which focused on imaging blood flow in the brain. And so they looked at blood flow in eight key brain regions. The patients also completed the standard medical assessment for neck pain called the Neck Disability Index. All right. Plus they were evaluated to see if they had subluxations. All right. So they were then assigned to three different groups. Group one was mild, consisted of 14 patients. Among this group, cerebral perfusion measured was normal in all eight brain regions. Okay, so if they just had mild, it didn't affect their brains. Okay, however, group two and group three. So group two would be moderate, consisted of 16 patients, and the imaging indicated a 20 to 35% decrease in cerebral perfusion among these patients. Mm. Most of the reduced blood flow occurred in the parietal, and that's where all sensory stuff is kind of integrated. And the frontal zones of the brain. That's where planning, activities, executive organs. So if you're finding you feel stupid, you can't figure out, well, what am I doing? I was going to do these three things. If I don't write them down, I don't do them. You know, these.
Sure.
You could have some hypoperfusion of your brain because your bones in your neck and your upper back are misaligned.
Wow. Wow.
Really? Isn't something
which is affecting the blood flow?
Yes,
and everything
so
else.
That's right. Your ability then to think, because that's uh-huh. the amount of oxygen, this nourishment, and flushing out the all this sort of stuff. So group three consisted of 15 patients, and the imaging indicated a 30 to 45% decrease. So these people who had these chronic problems, and the more severe they were, it actually had a negative, just a profound impact on their perfusion. Again, predominantly in the parietal, so that's sensory. So now what most people would experience would be diminished. You wouldn't hear someone talking to you, you wouldn't notice as much. You'd kind of be walking like you've got blinders on.
Mm.
And that people would say, I've been talking to you, you didn't notice. You know, all these, if you're hearing those sorts of things, or and your hearing's okay, but you're not paying attention to things around you. That's the sort of stuff. So what is wrong in your neck and your upper back may be causing that. So the parietal zone is instrumental in coordinating sensory input from the body and also spatial sense and vision. The frontal zone coordinates everything, memory, preventing mental health problems, and so forth. So anyhow, so that's something, if you want an assessment in our office, if we've got a Valentine's Day special, this would be a great chance to actually check and see. And what I can do is I can look and see if I find any subluxations in your neck, upper back, or mid-back. And if you have those there, the likelihood is fairly high that your brain is not getting as much nourishment and oxygen and all that sort of stuff that it needs to function. So coming in for chiropractic adjustment really may not be about back pain or neck pain or whatever. It may actually be about improving your brain function. So another thing that's crazy, I don't know if any of you guys saw this article about the fertility issue. If you take too much Motrin, did you see that study that was just published? Oh my goodness.
So they're talking about Motrin
yes,
affecting...
Yes, yes, sperm count.
Wow.
So what we know, because the problem is, okay, if you don't go to a chiropractor, then what most people are doing is they go to their drugstore and they get these things over the counter. It's real easy to buy the ibuprofens, the Advils, the acetaminophen, the Tylenols, all those sorts of things. And we feel like they're safe because they're so common and everybody does it, that sort of thing. Well, they actually tested, because they were looking, they say, wait a minute here. They now have decided that women who are pregnant, if they actually take these Advils and even acetaminophen, the Tylenols, when they're pregnant, and if they happen to be carrying a little baby boy, then the chances of a problem in the boy's gonadal development things is profound. So they've started to worry about that. But they said nobody's ever tested it just in men. So they took some 35-year-old men, and they said, and they gave 1,200 milligrams. So this is not a lot. If you talk to your medical doctor, if they give you 800 milligram tablets and have you take three of them to get to 24, that's twice the dosage of this study. This study was only 1,200. Okay,
wow, that's crazy.
And
that's
so crazy. What they did is they measured to see what would happen. And so this was done in Denmark and France. It involved 31 adult men under the age of 35. And it was over a six-week period. They had a placebo for the other people. Within 2 weeks, testosterone-producing hormones in the ibuprofen subjects became tied to the amount of ibuprofen in their blood. The ratio of such hormones to testosterone dropped, causing compensated hypogonadism. The disorder is also linked to depression and strokes, a study's authors notes. So what we've got to do, there's a universal depression of important aspects of testicular function, including testosterone production after use of over-the-counter ibuprofen. Mm. And so there, you know, that's what they were studying. But the question is that also true of Tylenol and stuff? And so if you're trying to get pregnant or anything like that, this is affecting. And they talk. I got the whole study. So yeah. If you're interested, just let me know. But the title is called Ibuprofen Alters Human Testicular Physiology to Produce a State of Compensated Hypogonadism. So it's really. So if you're trying to get pregnant, and or you're trying to get, and you're a guy and you're going out and you're working in a construction field and you're taking. You're taking Advil or Motrin, you're down in those sorts of things, and your wife isn't getting pregnant. Hey, wait a minute. Let's think about that.
Just think about it.
Right. Then maybe that's an element, right? If you haven't thought about it, that was the first thing, that was this year, January of this year. So we're talking a couple weeks old. So let's get this. Let's think about this. And then the question is, well, instead of the pills, wouldn't it make more sense to actually find out what's wrong and why are you taking them in the first place and maybe get your spine working better, get your nerve system working better? It's kind of like a two-for-one, right? you can avoid taking the medicines, and on top of that, not only we get everything working better, you know, and you're in less pain and you have more energy and you can hear and perceive things better. It's a win-win.
Okay, so let's real quickly before we go here, flu, okay. Flighty,
yeah.
Flu-fighty.
Yes.
I'm thinking of the Foo Fighters for some reason. Flu fighting strategies,
yes.
A special seminar coming up. That is going to be February 20th,
that's
6
Tuesday
until
night.
7
yep.
p.m. And so there's info on your website,
yes.
Regarding
yes.
that, daychiropractic.com. And then also want to mention the Valentine's
yes.
special.
Yes. So basically, if you come in, we'll do a full workup. We ask that you make a donation of at least $25 to Oak La Haven, and that's at Children's Center in Oklahoma City, where they take care of children with special needs. So your donation will then, we'll apply that as if you paid us, and we'll do a wonderful comprehensive workup. So like if you're having any of these problems with a smell or any of these other issues, and you want to see if it might be because there's a subluxation somewhere in your spine, we can actually analyze your nerve system, and we'll do the full workup like we would anybody else. And it's our way of saying thank you to you and for making that contribution, and it lets us kind of live our mission and passion.
All right, here's the phone number for Day Chiropractic. 503-760-7572, 503-760-7572. Thank you, Dr. Day.
Thank you.
And our Northwest Showcase this afternoon, sponsored by Day Chiropractic. Go to daychiropractic.com and find out more as well. My name is Andy West. This has been the Northwest Showcase on 93.9 KPDQ.